We've made it then. What's our first order of business, Arisen?
Well met, sir. I was
expecting
you there.
Polishing my armor can wait till the morning.
Those recruits don't know how to fight.
I don't
turn
this.
Everyone's as tired as I am.
Seems like. My patience wears a little thinner.
What is it? Has something happened? You ought at least rest for the evening. There should be a spare bed in the lodgings yonder. Only don't go rushing off before you're ready. Take it from me. You're better off resting while you have the chance.
Stick my head where it will get cut off.
My bed cords and a sharp resist.
It's hard to find my footing in this darkness.
What purpose does this contraption serve? Perhaps you might investigate, Arisen.
Will be ready to respond, whatever the outcome.
Well now, I'm a lucky man. Thought I was waiting here for naught. But when someone finally does come along, 'tis you. I've always wanted a real fight with you, one on one. Here's my chance.
Holding back on me, are you? Sir.
It is Sir Ragnar. I've not heard a whisper of the man since you parted ways with the king. Yet there he stands.
He seems to desire a bout. You ought to fight him alone. We shall await you here. Best of luck to you.
his mind to command. Curses. This arrival of the true risen is most inopportune. Sovereign of Vermin, the ritual must not be disturbed. Let not the arisen approach. You can manage that, I trust.
It is of vital import that we have a word with these faces.
Arisen, to me. I shall heal you. Wait a moment.
Efforts are for naught, Arisen. Now, simply watch as this world's hollow and fruitless order is remade by my hand. The ritual is complete. The dragon comes. Behold! The Royce Dragon! By my power, the dogma of dragons is unmade. You could ne'er understand, Arisen. We must all be freed from the vulgar order wherein the dragon's existence determines all.
Greetings, Arisen. Hast thou summoned the resolution to face me? Then answer me this. Why dost thou fight? Is it to reclaim thy flesh, thy stolen heart? Or is it to reclaim thy throne? I offer thee a choice. Grant unto me this life in my claws, and be gone from this place. Or stand and fight. Pitiable Arisen. The time for thou to make thy choice is come. Show me the path thou wouldst walk. Go, and thou shalt live to claim thy coveted throne. fight and thy life is forfeit. Thou wilt... Intriguing. This then is thy will. Our parley is done. We must fulfill our charges. I as the dragon, and thou as the arisen. Climb upon me. We shall depart for our true battlefield.
Stay away.
Pray. Turn back.
Leave now, while you can.
You have strayed, Arisen. And for what? Lest you forget. You have a world where you belong. There, you are to fell the great evil in your path and rule the people as their sovereign. For that is who you are. And it is my wish that you should live out that life of purpose. The time has come for you to return. Go. My children shall see you there safely.
Let us go home. Together.
To a world under your rightful rule.
To a world all your own.
This is your will? Then behold, a world unmerciful, left with benevolent hands and eyes. find it strange. But this is your world. The world to which you longed to return. Alas, if only you had chosen to become sovereign. At the end of your travails, you could have ruled over these lands in perpetual peace. Yet that world of limitless possibilities has ended. You stand now upon its remains, the vestiges of a world that could have been so much more. Innumerable wills have served to deliver this world from extinction time and time again. You alone have refused to carry out that great purpose. What you see before you is the consequence of your apathy. Behold. You're in this world, abandoned and unprotected.
Since times of eld, dragon blood has been used to refine all.
Remember, draconic blood flows through the veins of lesser.
This world is far removed from the one I know.
Then go. Since times of eld.
Remember, draconic blood flows through the veins.
Of lesser drakes as well. Bring me what ye reap, and I shall harness it.
Then I bid ye farewell.
No purchases to be made today, I see. I just hope the shopkeeper understands.
The Arisen is ever prudent in the application of coin. I shall take this. Your pawn is nowhere to be seen. Master.
Put back your scale!
To retreat, then?
Let us defer to the Arisen's judgment.
You have my support.
Standing, we might say otherwise.
We mustn't allow ourselves to become complacent. Take each trial as it comes.
A burden arisen. What has become of the world? Would that there was... save our best will do. Your aid.
Another encounter? Thank you, Arisen. You've been doused in oil. Aught fell from the beast that had breathed its last.
Ah!
Let me get that.
What has become of the world? Would that there be someone who could explain this madness?
And to think of it, did not Cerathea speak of releasing the world from its bonds in the Seafloor Shrine?
If this is indeed the world unbound, then perhaps we ought to seek out his wisdom.
Another battle with nary a moment to breathe!
Thank you. Your pawn is nowhere to be seen, Master. But where would a pawn possibly go, leaving their own master behind?
Perhaps this too is Lord Phasus' doing. We ought to go and speak with him at the Forbidden Magic Research Lab.
Pray, allow me to open your chest. These fiends are only defeated when their skulls are smashed beyond the air. Dare I say it? We trounced our foe, well and true.
What has become of the world? Would that there were someone who could explain this madness.
Come to think of it, did not Seraphia speak of releasing the world from its bonds in the Seafloor Shrine?
If this is indeed the world unbound, then perhaps we ought to seek out his wisdom.